man, you're watching the Daily Brew right here on PTN.
Good morning, coffee drinkers and news seekers, and welcome to a Sunday edition of The Brew, where we're drinking our favorite coffee, and we are now going to be permanently right here on Sundays for you. We are reading the stories of the emergence of World War III. Let's get right to the news. Ukraine mobilizes reserve troops, threatening war. Russia's move to seize control of Ukraine's Crimean Peninsula on Saturday led Ukraine's unelected government to call up its military reserves on Sunday and warn Moscow against further incursions as Western powers scramble to find a response to the crisis. A day after the Russian parliament granted President Vladimir Putin broad authority to use military force in response to the political upheaval in Ukraine that dislodged its democratically elected government and installed a new, staunchly pro-New World Order government, the Ukrainian unelected government in Kiev threatened war if Russia sent troops further into the Ukraine. The announcement of the reserves' mobilization was an attempt to the rattled new government in Kiev to draw a line against Mr. Putin. In related news, Ukraine orders combat readiness, calls up military reserves. Ukraine crisis tests Obama's foreign policy focus and diplomacy over military force. For much of his time in office, President Barack Hussein Obama has been accused of a mix of conservative hawks and liberal interventionalists of overseeing a dangerous retreat from the world at a time when American influence is needed. The New World Order-backed Arab Spring has disintegrated into civil war and military coup. China is stepping up its territorial claims in the waters off East Asia. Longtime allies in Europe and the Persian Gulf are worried by the inconsistency of a president who came into office promising the end of the United States by fundamentally changing the country. In other news, Ralph Nader, Obama the Executioner. In his new book, Ralph Nader calls for the end of unconstitutional wars and unchecked militarization, and lays blame on President Barack Hussein Obama for going beyond even George W. Bush. Nader writes in Unstoppable that Obama has extended the Bush Doctrine by declaring his own unilateral right as secret prosecutor, judge, jury, and executioner to destroy anybody anywhere in the world, including American citizens, suspected to be engaged in alleged terrorist activity, with all this vaguely and loosely defined as anti-U.S. security. The Imperial President. Members of Congress and unconstitutional law experts testified before the House Judiciary Committee on Wednesday, warning that the legislative branch is in danger of seceding its power in face of an imperial president. More news. IRS warns Obamacare tax must be paid with tax return. Agency employees Orwellian term shared responsibility payment to describe Obama's individual mandate tax. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, they've delayed the corporate tax, they've delayed the corporate mandate, and they, of course, have subsidized all of Congress so that the American taxpayer actually has to pay Congress's and their staffers' health care. We subsidize it. But not the American people. No, every individual must have healthcare insurance, health insurance. Otherwise, you will be fined. Mm-hmm. And what happens when you don't pay your fine to the IRS? Well, they come take all your stuff. So, in other words, if you don't pay your fine to Obamacare, not having health insurance, if you don't have it, well, guess what? The IRS will come get your stuff. Illinois hires convicted terrorist as Obamacare navigator. Oh, Oh, hey, that's great. Obama seems to love terrorists anyways. He's working with Al-Qaeda in Syria. So why not have them work on Obamacare? That's a perfect place for them. Don't you agree? And finally, ladies and gentlemen, in the Sunday edition of the Daily Brew, brace yourself for Hillary and Jeb. They're saying in 2016, that is, that Hillary and Jeb Bush will be the leading, I guess, candidates for the presidential nomination. That is, if President Barack Hussein Obama doesn't find a way to keep himself in there with some kind of national emergency, where he declares the national emergency, martial law, or whatever, and tries to keep himself in power. Okay, folks, that's it for the Daily Brew, or the Brew, the Sunday Brew. I'm here, John LeBang, saying thank you. If you liked it, please sub, like, and share, and favorite. I'd really appreciate it. You can follow me on Twitter, and also you can email me at jlebang@live.com, and my website, www.jlebang.com. And until next time, folks, have a great day, and oh, one other thing. I think I'm going to do a live broadcast tonight on Google Plus around 8 p.m. tonight. So keep an eye out for that, because I think we're going to talk about what is going on with the Ukraine and the possible emergence of World War III real soon. Thank you, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you later. Bye.